Please welcome Fatboy Slim.
Good evening.
Oh, Mr. Slim, we appreciate you getting up for us so early in the morning over there where you are. And look, last time we spoke to you in January 2020, it was right before COVID hit. Here you are later that same year. Now, I've got to ask, did anyone have a better lockdown than Fatboy Slim? Look at that. That looks pretty picturesque to me.
Yes. You know what? I actually ended up spending most of lockdown working in my cafe, serving coffees and burgers.
Oh, wow.
So it wasn't all fun and games like that.
Geez, that breaks my heart that even you did hospitality during lockdown.
it was worse for the people I was serving. No, actually, I was quite good. I really enjoyed it. No, I think we all did what we could to maintain whatever kind of... sense of community or still being together. So working in the cafe was really good to get me out of the house and keep me greased up.
Just a latte with Fatboy Slim milk. Thanks very much. Anyway, Fatboy Slim, you're doing some shows here in Australia next year. Are you finding a whole new generation of fans want to be Rockefeller skanked, or are you finding it's more of the diehards that are still filling out the crowds?
It's actually a healthy mixture of both, I think. Because I'm sort of playing clubs a lot and sort of appealing to younger people. So for me, it's like the people down the front are always quite young, but then you can see at the back there's the older ones. So it's a bit of both. I think it's a very mixed bag, united by the desire for escapism.
You appear in the Woodstock 99 documentary, which is about the disastrous reboot of the Woodstock Festival. Was that festival the worst gig you've ever played?
It wasn't the worst, but it was probably in my top five.
Oh, wow.
It was one of the hairier nights of my life. But I mean, the actual show wasn't too bad. I mean, the proper violence and burning of stuff hadn't started on the Saturday night. So, but it was quite a fruity show.
So if that was in the top five, can I ask, what was the worst? And when's the documentary coming about that?
No, the worst gig for a DJ is when no one dances. If they're getting all lively and overexcited, then that means you're doing your job right.
Oh, OK. When they came and asked you to do that documentary, were you happy to do it, or would you have rather just forgotten the whole thing?
I had forgotten a lot of it because you don't tend to remember. I mean, it was like after the show, everyone sort of went, oh, how was Woodstock? I'm like, oh, it's all right. I wasn't sort of traumatised by it or anything. It was quite nice to revisit it later when you're not, when you're not so worried about it.
Because you are here next year, Mr. Slim, I have to ask, are there any Aussie artists that you would love to be working with? Can we expect any collaborations?
Well, I did just do a remix for Lime Cordial.
Oh, fantastic.
With Idris Elba, a tune called Holiday. I don't know. I mean, Fisher I like. Do you know Fisher?
Yes, I do.
We play a lot. We DJ a lot together and I do love him very, very dearly. Mm. But probably the person I'm most likely to collaborate lives here in Brighton, Nick Cave.
Oh, brilliant.
Musically, we're miles apart, but we bump into each other often, and I do love him. He's a fabulous man.
When's it coming? When can we organise that?
Well, don't hold your breath.
I've got to be honest, what I hear right here, right now, it instantly transports me back to Bondi, 2006, New Year's Eve. I was actually wearing a trucker hat. I don't know if you found it afterwards, but anyway.
Was it a yellow, mellow trucker hat?
Yeah.
I remember you. I remember what you were doing as well.
That's good because he doesn't.
Yeah. Mr. Slim, we're at a 6:30 time slot. Please don't repeat any of that. Do any of your songs transport you back to a time like that?
Well, not really. I mean, I find it's probably other people's music has more an emotional effect on me because obviously the tunes I've done, I kind of know how they were made, so there isn't that magic and beauty, I do remember I was recording a tune called Demons with Macy Gray in LA when I found out I was going to be a father. And whenever I hear that, it just reminds me of that feeling of impending fatherhood.
Oh, beautiful. And we've recently learned that you actually used to be neighbours with Paul McCartney. What's he like as a neighbour?
He was lovely. He was lovely. Very very congenial neighbour. Would appear on my back door going, only me, just come home for a cuppa, which is, you never normalise living two doors down from a Beatle.
It's quite a street with Fatboy Slim, Paul McCartney and Nick Cave.
I don't know if they're asking each other for a cup of sugar every now and again.
Yeah, it's a strange little street. I know, because Adele used to live down our street as well.
Oh, my God. You've dropped some names. You've got to pick them up.
That's a heck of a Christmas party right there.
Well, Fatboy Slim will be hitting up Melbourne, Brisbane, Sydney and Perth in April and May next year. Head to our website for all of the details. Thank you so very, very much, Fatboy Slim, for dropping by.
Thank you.